Rozie Perez is communicating with boxing fans all the time. If there's a fight card on, Rozie's out there chatting with boxing fans about what she's watching. I'm proud to say she's my friend, and I'd like her to come up and say a few words. The great Rozie Perez.
Hi, Lennox. Hi, everybody. So, I am a fanatic. I was having a meeting with someone today. He wanted to pick my brain about boxing. And I was telling him about this wonderful female boxer who didn't get the attention that she deserved. And her name is Clarissa Shields. And he said, how do you know about Clarissa Shields? And I said, And I said, I know, because this is what I love. And I am one of the most ultimate fans. And I was hearing you earlier, and I don't think that applies to Lennox Lewis. Yes, he didn't get a certain amount of attention because he wasn't cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. That's not a slight to you, Mike. We have similar issues, so I understand. I don't know if it's a Brooklyn thing or what, but you know, man, Brooklyn's tough. But I always regarded him as a special fighter. And there was one time my cousin Sixto and I was going to the Garden, and Lennox was sitting all by himself, and it was the pre-fight party HBO was putting on. I don't know if you even remember this. And he had a plate of food that was this high. And I said, oh my God, that motherfucker could eat. And Sixto was like, you numb nut, he's the heavyweight, of course he eats. And so I was like, oh, let's go over and say hi. No, I'm too shy. All right, let's do it. And we went over to say hi. And he was such a gentleman. He was so quiet. He was like this quiet, gentle giant. And it threw me. It really did. And, you know, because it's, you know that old saying, be careful if you meet your heroes because sometimes they could turn out to be assholes. It's not said that way, but you get what I mean. So he was just a really, really nice person. And then the next time I saw him, we were in this restaurant called Negril on 14th Street. Do you remember that? He was sitting again with a mound of food. And my cousin Sixto said, oh my God, there goes Lennox Lewis. I go, where? He goes, behind you, don't look. I go, I gotta look. He goes, don't look. I go, oh my God, how's my hair? Right? And yeah, you must be Latin. So, you know, we went over to him. Do you remember that? We went over to you and...
And then the Foot Locker party.
Shut up, I'm getting to it. You can't bring Puerto Ricans anywhere. Jesus, Christmas. So, look at Mike's excited to see you six, though. Another crazy Brooklyn night. So, he was gracious once again. And I remember Sixto saying to Lennox, what are you doing sitting here all by yourself? And he goes, I'm eating. And I said, I get you. I didn't have an entourage. He didn't have an entourage. He was just a man who was looking for some good food and just doing his thing. And I was so impressed with that. And then the next time, thank you, Sixto. You know what? Now I'm going to embarrass your ass. I wasn't going to say this.
It was a party.
Yes, it was a Foot Locker benefit for AIDS. We go there. My cousin Sixto tries to pimp me out to this certain football player so that he could get Baltimore Raven Super Bowl tickets. Swear to God. He comes over to me and he says, oh, this guy wants to see you. What's it? I said, who? This football player. I go, what's his name? Don't worry about it. He's a real nice guy. And I go, what? He goes, come on, help me out, Super Bowl. Right? He goes, he's going to come over and sit next to you. I go, who? Yeah. Ray Lewis sits next to me. I go, you got to be fucking kidding me. And then behind Ray Lewis's back, Sixto's going,
get closer.
Yeah. On the ride home, when Ray Lewis called me, and I didn't give him my phone number, but my cousin did. I remember saying to Sixto, well, they all can't be gentlemen like Lennox Lewis. We walked into that event. He was the first person there. And I asked for your autograph on a glove. And Sixto asked for one too.
I got it.
And Sixto and I were fighting because you could only do one glove. And you said, oh, don't fight. Y'all are family. Here, I'll just sign another glove.
Aww.
And it was just so nice, you know? He wasn't up on murder charges.
Ha ha ha!